I'd like to thank all of you for coming here at short notice. I was not intending to hold a press conference, but after my letter, which I acknowledge that I wrote, appeared in a newspaper today, in the Hindu today, I thought it's my duty to clarify my position, and that is why I requested all of you to come here. It's an extremely painful and in fact a very heartrending day for me. It's an extremely painful moment for me because my family has been associated with Indian National Congress since the inception. I am a fourth generation Congress worker. My great grandfather was a member of the Constituent Assembly. All the members of my family, obviously not I, have been imprisoned in the freedom movement. My grandfather was the last Congress Chief Minister. In fact, in 1967, after the late revered Kamaraj, Mr. Bhaktavatsalam was the Congress Chief Minister. So I come from a family which has Congress blood flowing in our veins. We have deep association and it is a way of life. So from my youth, from youth Congress days, Congress blood runs in my veins. And therefore, for me, it's an extremely anguished moment that it has come to this position when I have to rethink my association with the Congress party. I'm in such an emotional moment that I've jotted down the main points that I want to raise before you, and I feel that the time has come now for me to rethink my association because of what happened in the recent past, that the Congress is no longer the Congress which I joined with such great hopes and ideals. And I had a 30-year long association with the Congress. I want to remind you that with extreme gratitude to my Congress, which has given me an opportunity in the Rajya Sabha, not even Lok Sabha, in the Rajya Sabha, to serve this country. And I would like to remind you, all of you are from my own state. I have served without blemish, without a single blemish, from 1986, both when the party was in power and outside power. And I have been spokesperson of my party for 10 long years, without a single blemish being there in my career. And I'm extremely grateful to my party and my leadership for whatever opportunities were given to me to serve the nation and to serve the party. And I continue to maintain that I serve the nation and the party with tremendous dedication to the best of my ability. But today, the party and the values which I joined, it is no longer the same party that I believed in and that I joined. And the reasons are this. I have written in this letter, which I have written to the party president, Madam Sonia Gandhi, that I was a member of parliament and I was made Minister of Environment. And when I was made Minister of Environment, the party line was very clear that the policy of Srimati Indira Gandhi, that the policy of Sri Rajiv Gandhi to preserve the environment, it must be protected at all costs. And therefore, it was my duty to make sure that every single step I took, no matter how popular or unpopular, should be strictly according to law, according to rules, and preserve the environment at all costs, despite any interest to the contrary. This was the party line. This was explained to me by my leadership. And as I continued my duties as minister, I received several instructions from the office of Vice President Sri Rahul Gandhi, forwarding requests, forwarding representations from NGOs who complained about environmental deterioration due to some large projects. And I was asked by his office and by him to make sure that environment is protected at all costs and to ensure that these large projects don't cause tremendous havoc to the environment. And according to these instructions, which I perceive to be directions and the party line, and I myself believe that the environment should be protected at all costs, I did my duty, I did due diligence, I had these projects investigated, and some of them I stopped, and they were great investment projects. Many of my colleagues in the cabinet protested strongly. There were very heated discussions in cabinet. Very often I had to face the anger and wrath of all my colleagues in the ministry and in the cabinet who felt that economic progress was being blocked. But I had to keep on telling them that environment projects have to make sure that the environment and the future is not destroyed at all costs. And I therefore had followed fully the party line with the support of the party and under instructions from my leader. Madam Gandhi was also interested in forest rights. She wrote to me several times making sure forest rights should be protected. Several projects, especially roads, had to be studied in the view of rights of forest dwellers. Sri Rahul Gandhi was interested in the rights of tribals being protected. All these reasons made me stop several big projects, particularly Vedanta, the Niyamgiri project, which Sri Rahul Gandhi himself said that to the tribals that he will be their Sipahi. It was later upheld in the Supreme Court also. I followed my due diligence. The Nirma project, where the cement plant was being sought to be built on a water body, again upheld by the Supreme Court. And there were many projects, the Adani project, where I received specific input from NGOs who had represented to Sri Rahul Gandhi. And especially with the Adani project, there was specific input which was given to me from his office, forwarding representations from NGOs. And all that forms a part of the letter which I have written to Madam Sonia Gandhi, and my views and my decisions were taken accordingly. Suddenly on 20th December, so my first point is that I served the country and I was a good environment minister following the instructions of my high command, the party line, despite the fact that several of my cabinet colleagues were against the views I had taken. The second issue is on around the 17th of November, when I was on tour, I received a phone call from then chairman of the media cell, Sri Ajay Makan, asking me to immediately come back to Delhi. When I asked him why, he said that I was asked to launch an attack on Sri Narendra Modi, who was then the prime ministerial candidate of the BJP, on Snoopgate. So I said that I was a minister, and after I had become minister, I had been stopped from doing press briefings, and it should not be taken as a view of government, and I should not, and I think the spokesperson should do it. But Shri Ajay Makan said that this was a view taken at the highest level. I also said I'm not happy because I think we should attack him on policy and not on issues such as this. But again, he repeated it was a view taken at the highest level, and therefore I was asked to return to Delhi, and against my own wishes, following the party high command, I attacked Shri Modi, and on television subsequently, I was deputed only for this purpose to attack Shri Modi on Snoopgate. Following that, this was on 17th November. Following that, on 20th December, when many of my decisions were being heatedly discussed and argued, they were being overruled by the group of ministers. I was in complete opposition with many of my colleagues in cabinet due to the party line. And around the 20th of December, the Prime Minister called me and he told me that he wants to see me. When I went to meet him, he looked very upset. Prime Minister looked very tense, very grim. He got up and he said that you have been, Madam has said, Mrs. Gandhi has said that you are required for party work. So I said, sir, what do you want me to do? And he said, she wants you to resign. So I said, yes, sir, I'll do that. And within half an hour, I gave my resignation. I immediately asked for an appointment with Congress President, but I was told she'll speak to me on the phone. I spoke to her on the phone and she said, yes, you are required for party work. Please follow Prime Minister's instructions. Next day in the media, it appeared, the same thing appeared, but I heard from friends in the Delhi media that Sri Rahul Gandhi's office was phoning up people and saying that this is not for party work at all, but she's just, they didn't give a reason. And after that, there was a continuous campaign of speculation, vilification, of defamation, wrong allegations against me, allegations of wrongdoing, nothing which has ever been brought to my notice. At the time I resigned, I have the letter here, I'll distribute it once again, I distributed it on that day also. Honorable Prime Minister wrote a letter praising me for the contribution as council, as a member of the Council of Ministers. No wrongdoing was pointed out by anybody. Thereafter, I met the Honorable Congress President in January. I told her I'm being vilified and defamed in the media and I would like to respond. She told me not to go to the media. She said that I will be given party work. I came back to Chennai and within 15 or 20 days, I received another phone call from Sri Ajay Makan that I'm sorry, tomorrow the new list of spokespersons are coming and you are being removed from the panel, which was again a shock to me because several times Madam Congress President as well as Honorable Prime Minister have praised me for my contribution as spokesperson. So I have no idea why I was removed as spokesperson. After that, when the Anthony Committee called upon leaders to find out why we lost in the Lok Sabha elections, on several other occasions, I was not, neither consulted, nor called, nor sidelined. My issues are all with the National High Command in Delhi. I want to put on record, I have no issues with the state party at all. Everybody in the state party have always cooperated with me. So I was totally sidelined by the National High Command and several times I asked for an appointment to meet Congress President. I went to Delhi. I was never given an appointment. I wrote a passionate email to Sri Rahul Gandhi to say that because the main point that I want to make in one of the main points I want to make in the press conference, 20th of December when I was asked to resign, the next day on 21st of December, Sri Rahul Gandhi addressed a meeting of FICCI leaders where he assured them that environment will no longer be a bottleneck. When I saw this on YouTube, I was alerted by media. I was very upset because the main hard line on environment was given by him. And he himself was, if he had a problem, he could have told me to do the clearances faster. But he himself was going to asking me to go the day before he addresses FICCI, and the next day he's telling FICCI that environment clearances will now become much more easy, whereas there was really no bottleneck, there was really no problem. Two important issues, Kasturi Rangan report, which I notified the day before I was sent home, and one particular file of Adani group which was missing and found in a bathroom. The next day, I was asked to resign. When I wrote an email to Sri Rahul Gandhi saying, very passionate, saying, I saw your speech in FICCI. I want to know why you did this. You have never said that I was holding up projects. Whatever I did because you asked me to do. I got a reply, and even a murderer has his day in court, is what I wrote to Sri Rahul Gandhi, to which he replied, I am a little busy right now and I will call you soon. But that appointment never materialized. I was unable to meet either him or Madam Gandhi. Then Mr. Vasan split the party, as you know, he formed his own party. Day before Mr. Vasan formed his own party, I was called by Motilal Vora to find out and to be asked to stay in the party. That was the first contact I had from any senior leader in the Congress. After that, I wrote this letter. It is dated, I think, the 9th of November. Actually, I sent it about 2 weeks later. I can give you the exact, because I still kept it. It was a very painful thing for me. But definitely by the end of November or first week of December, I've got the receipts for it. She received it. And I did not get a reply. I did not get a phone call. I did not even get an acknowledgement. Then I told a few colleagues in the Congress that I'm now going to the media. I'm going to the media because it's not about party work. It's not about serving. It's not about power. Doing party work, I have been a faithful, loyal, dedicated servant of the party, utter loyalist of the Gandhi family. I have no shame in saying this. I was there when Sri Rajiv Gandhi was assassinated. I was with the body the whole night. But why I was sent home, why for 1 year everybody was allowed to ruin my reputation, ruin the glorious legacy of my family, this is something that I'm not able to digest or tolerate. And I felt that if I'm not getting an explanation from my party, there's no democracy in my party, then I have to go to the public with my side of the events. I'm not guilty of any. Prime Minister himself has written to me saying that I've done a wonderful job. Nobody has ever accused me of wrongdoing, just some vested interests within the party by spreading innuendo and falsehoods and lies and putting them in newspapers with vested interests without attributing it to sources. These people, I have to place the record straight that so far nobody has ever given me any concrete allegation of any wrongdoing that I've, and I have committed no wrongdoing. If anybody is able to show that I've done anything wrong, I'm willing to be hanged. I'm willing to go to jail. But I want to stand proud, uphold my family's legacy. If I'm not able to work in the Congress party, if I'm not able to uphold the legacy of my family, I place on record my gratitude to the party for having given me this opportunity. But in this suffocating atmosphere, whereby lies and falsehood and innuendo and other people, my reputation is vilified and ruined, I cannot function in this atmosphere anymore. Therefore, today I announce my resignation from as a primary member of the Congress from the Tamil Nadu Congress Committee trustee, which is not morally correct for me to hold once I'm no longer a primary member of the Congress. So I resign from my position as a trustee. I have not yet sent the letter. I'm making the announcement here, and the letter of resignation I will send to the Congress President and to the State President from the Tamil Nadu Congress Committee Trust today after this press conference. And I want to reiterate that I am only wanting to set the record straight to uphold the legacy of my family, to uphold my integrity, and the fact that I only did what I was asked to do by my party. I only did the right thing for the country, and I'm not guilty of any wrongdoing, and I need to set the record straight. I'm free to take any questions.
Madam, during his UPA 2, you said Mr. Rahul Gandhi was interfering in terms of asking you to clear or not to clear projects. Who was in rule? Was it the Prime Minister or was it Sonia Gandhi or Mr. Rahul Gandhi?
I did not use the word interfered. I want to be very specific in what I'm saying. I said, my letter we'll distribute to all of you now. I said that I received specific input regarding some projects. I received those projects, I've mentioned the names in the letter. I received input via representations from NGOs, which were sent to Sri Rahul Gandhi and he sent them to me. I received input whereby he said, please look into this and see that this environmental degradation is not allowed. And that was like a directive for me. So I took the initiative to do it. And it was by way either one of their assistants talking to me. It was basically only Sri Rahul Gandhi. Congress President wrote letters to me in her capacity as UPA chairperson, which are on record in some cases, to look into it. And Sri Rahul Gandhi forwarded the NGO letters and his aides, and I was sometimes asked to liaison with specific AICC office bearers to help those NGOs to ensure that the environment is not degraded. One by one. I'll answer Sandhya. I'll answer her.
Just a little while ago you said that if Rahul Gandhi had told you that he would, you know, what was in his mind, that he wanted you to fast track environmental clearances, you would have done so. So what, where does your role as a minister come in? You know, are you just following Rahul Gandhi's directives?
No, that's an excellent question. It is not fast tracking. That is not the issue. My entire point is this. At every stage, whether Shri Rahul Gandhi requested me or not, I only followed the rules. I didn't break the rules. But in specific cases, I was told that there should be on no account environmental degradation. Therefore, I appointed committees to go and study and make sure whether there was degradation or not. And I took a very hard line. In case Shri Gandhi had wanted that there should be fast tracking of projects for clearances, then the rules would have to be amended. According to the amended rules, I would have taken action. So my point is, I was never told by him that I was holding up projects. As he spoke in Fiki the next day,